People, I told you all, did I tell you all this guy was going down? No, he admitting that he did send the photos, huh? I missed the beginning of the news conference, but y'all gonna get to see it, okay? I'm gonna wait for Brooke to come on and give us the story. But he admitted. You see, people? Guy, he was a part of the financial base. He's part of it. Okay, he's part of that Rothschild clan, okay? He's part of that banksters clan, okay? He's just one of their plants. And we're gonna hunt them out. We're gonna seek them out. We're gonna hunt them and we're gonna find them. Every one of them who have any dealing with doing to bring America down. We're gonna hunt you.
An idea that I accept responsibility for, but if you're looking for some kind of deep explanation for it, I simply don't have one. Except that I'm sorry. I didn't think of it that way. From time to time, I would say to myself, this is a mistake, or this conversation someone could listen in on or translate to someone else. I know that there is the sense that everything is part of a plan and it was thought through and calculated. In this case, it was just me doing a very dumb thing, and for that I accept the responsibility. Yeah, sure.
Can you tell us when you come down and you can see the
I didn't see any of the pictures that were released today. I can tell you that there were some women that I had conversations with that the inappropriate things were sent by me, and I accept responsibility for that.
Did you ever
tell
anyone from
Mayor's
group?
The last thing on this day,
this is too easy.
I have done this harm to my wife and my family, that I'm standing before all of you and accepting responsibility for this shameful thing, is thinking about next year's election or the election after that.
Tell the children the truth.
Make sure that obviously this never ever happens again.
Tell the children the truth.
To my wife and to my family and to all the people that I've harmed.
Do you need professional help?
I have not, you know, I'm going to try to handle this, and I haven't ruled out perhaps seeing someone, but I'm not blaming anyone. This is not something that can be treated away. This is my own personal mistake. This is not something, this is a weakness, a deep weakness that I have demonstrated, and for that I apologize.
You're not sure about the time that you sent these pictures.
Some of these relationships, some of the date back is, I think, much as 3 years. Almost from the moment that I, you know, when you say something like that that's so wrong, I was embarrassed. And I didn't want it to lead to other embarrassing things. And it was a dumb thing to do, to try to tell lies about it, because it just led to more lies. But almost immediately after I said the lie, I knew that I was putting people in a very bad position, and I didn't want to continue doing it.
Tell the children the truth.
Excuse me?
Rebellion has begun.
No. Megan Prusad was one of the women.
When did you call your wife?
My wife has known about some of these online relationships since before we were married, and we spoke frankly about them but she didn't know until this morning that I had not been telling the truth about whether I posted the Twitter posting last week.
What do you say to Andrew Breitbart, who was accused of hacking your account by many left-wing blogs, and people on CNN, what do you say to them?
Well, I'm here primarily to express my apologies to my wife and family, but anyone who was misled, all of you who were misled, the people who I lied to, I have an apology for all of them.
But not specifically for him, not an apology?
I believe that everyone deserves an apology here, and I certainly am. I'm certain. I'll be saying here's what.
Where's your wife right now?
I apologize to Andrew Breitbart. I apologize to the many other members of the media that I misled. I apologize first and foremost to my wife and to my family.
Where is she right now? Where is she right now?
She is not here.
You're terrible. You are terrible for your bigotness.
I have a loving wife. It's not anything like that. I treated it as a frivolous thing, not acknowledging that it was causing harm to so many people.
And I guess terrible.
Yes, sir. I spoke briefly to Leader Pelosi before I came over here. She said to say what you know, and
again,
I was doing that.
Anthony Weiner standing up at that podium for just about half an hour, taking question after question after question from members of the media, essentially saying this, that he lied. That he lied to his wife, he lied to his constituents, he lied to members of the media, that photograph, that lewd photo, was in fact sent from him, intended to be a direct message to that woman in Seattle. Instead, it was tweeted out, and that is how this whole thing began. A couple of other notes I took: he did admit to engaging in multiple inappropriate conversations, all of this over social media, all of this with women who he was led to believe were of age 18 and older. He mentioned in total 6 women over the course of the last 3 years. He said that his wife, who, by the way, he has just married in the last year, in fact, President Clinton married them. She works at the State Department under Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. She was aware of some of these inappropriate relationships prior to their marriage, but according to Congressman Weiner just now, did not know until this morning that it was her husband who posted the twit pic from 2 Fridays ago. A couple quotes that stood out to me. He said, quote, "I haven't told the truth and have done things I deeply regret." Also, quote, "I regret what I've done and I am not resigning." Wolf Blitzer, I'm sure you have been watching this thing right along with me, right along with many, many people who've been watching CNN. And Wolf, it was you with whom he spoke last Wednesday, you to whom he said, "This wasn't me."
Yeah, you know, he was clearly lying, not just to his friends and his family, but he was lying to all of us, because I asked him several questions, and he now admits he didn't tell us the truth when I asked him specifically, did you send that picture to that woman in Washington State, that young college student? He said no, absolutely no, you know, and that obviously he's now acknowledging was a lie. When I said, what about other pictures, did you send other pictures? I said, you know, you knew if those were your underpants, for example. And, you know, he came up with a whole explanation about, you know, photos can be doctored. Sometimes you send stuff from one account and it looks like it's coming from another Twitter account. You know, all of that was now seen as a lie. So, you know, he was honest today. He should have been honest last week, because, as you know, Brooke, in Washington, it's always the cover-up, which is very often so much worse than the initial sin or crime, or if there was a crime or wrongdoing, whatever. But then when he went on television and he, you know, ridiculed and lambasted reporters, including our own Dana Bash and Ted Barrett, our excellent producer up on Capitol Hill, calling him a bad word, and I don't even want to repeat it right now. You know, it was just ridiculous. And then the next day, when he did that series of interviews with all the anchors and reporters in Washington, including a very long one with me, you know, it's just heartbreaking. And it's especially heartbreaking because those of us who know his wife, Huma, who's a wonderful woman who's worked for the Secretary of State for a long time, they've been married for less than a year, and it must be so painful for her, for her family, for his family, for all of their friends to see what's going through. And you saw him almost break down and cry
several
moments. He must be going through hell. And, you know, he obviously acknowledged at the end maybe he needs some therapy, maybe he needs some help to deal with these problems, because, you know, it's just a bad, bad situation all around.
Wolf, I know.
Babylon, your throne gone down, gone down. Babylon, your throne gone down. Not by power, nor by might, but by my spirit, said the Lord of hosts. Be gonna bring Babylon down. all of them who are involved in enslaving America. We're gonna bring you down. One love, my people. It has begun.